About 10:30 p.m. last night, emergency services were called to the intersection of Bridge Street near Pitt Street in the city, right in the middle of the Sydney CBD, following reports of a man being shot.
It's the most public escalation yet of a long-running Sydney crime war.
Initial identification of a man has been confirmed as 34-year-old Bilal Hamze. We believe he left in an establishment nearby, and then as he walked onto Bridge Street, he was shot down in a hail of bullets.
Bilal Hamze was a boss in the Brothers for Life crime gang, started by his cousin, Bassem Hamze. His CBD execution is the latest of more than a dozen shootings since internal disputes splintered the gang in 2012. Detectives will be exploring if Bilal's murder is fallout from Operation Ironside, the massive global police act that used a fake encrypted messaging app called Anom to intercept criminal communications.
There's been a major disruption across the criminal network, across not only Sydney but across the world. So we have a lot of lines of inquiry out of this shooting this morning.
Police also stressing that the brazenness of this CBD shooting will be met with force.
We'll be opening doors, we'll be kicking down doors, we'll be tipping people over, we'll be talking to them, we'll be harassing them within the bounds of the law to make sure that they know that we are there. There are going to be several arrests that flow from this.
Journalist Mark Murray has been working the Sydney crime beat at the Daily Telegraph since the Gangland murders of the 1980s, and he joins us now. Mark, what can you tell us about Bilal Hamze?
He's the cousin of Bassem Hamze, the founder of Brothers for Life, and part of the Hamze crime organisation that are very, very active in southwest Sydney. He was just released from jail last year. Since then, there's been a bit of a war going on between the Hamzes and the Alamedine crime syndicate, and he's been caught in the middle, and we saw what happened last night when that war exploded on the streets in one of the main streets of Sydney.
So did this come as a surprise to you as someone who covers this so closely?
Not particularly. He had a price on his head. He knew it for the last 2 months. Police have been telling him actively that he's got to be careful, that they know there are contracts out on his life. I'd also been told that by both police and members of the underworld that he was almost a dead man walking. And that's why he'd actually moved into the city to get away from his family in the southwest so that they weren't going to be possibly collateral damage when it did come. So I think he knew maybe it was coming.
What about Hamzy's mother? We understand even she's been targeted in this feud.
She's been shot as a result of conflict between the family and some other criminal organisations. You know, that was 7 or 8 years ago. So it shows you how long these conflicts have been going on and how they're indiscriminate, that they would actually just shoot a woman who actually just happened to open the door where they knew one of the family members were hiding. So it's a pretty worrying time for her. She has other family members that she must be very, very worried about if this continues to escalate.
We're not suggesting that the opposing family is involved in this killing, but what can you tell us of the history between the Hamzes and the Alamedines?
Look, it's been a long-running feud that's been going on for well over a decade, and there have been, it's territorial over drug money, potentially. There have been clashes in jail between different members of both groups. And as you said, we're not saying it would have to be the Alamedine group, because these different organisations in southwest, there's 4 or 5 syndicates and crime organisations all vying for the drug trade. So, you know, while this dispute is going on, another organisation might think, gee, this is a good time, I can get in there, we can get in there and take out one of these guys, and it'll have the conflict flaring, and while they're distracted, they try and take over some of their business.
Mark, do you think things will stop now with this execution, or could everything be about to get a lot worse?
So I'd expect there will be some more conflict. It definitely will be. There'll be members who knew Bilal. He was quite well liked amongst his fraternity, and they'll be seeking revenge. And as I said, they're very, very patient, as we've seen with this one with Bilal. You know, it's been a couple of months that the word's been out that he's going to be taking a bullet, and eventually they waited for their time and got it.
Look, thanks so much for your insights tonight, Mark.
Thank you.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.